Te in Civitatem Sanctum Jerusalem. Chorus Angelorum Te suscipiat, et cum Lazaro condem pauperia, aeternem habeas requiem. De profundis clamavi a Te, Domine, fiat aures Tuae intendes, in vocem deprecationis mea. Si iniquitates observeris, Domine, Domine quis sustinebit, quia apud Te propitiatio est, et propta legem tuam sustinuit, De Domine, sustinuit anima mea, in verbo eus speravit anima mea, in Domino. A custodia matutina usque ad noctem sperat, Israel in Domino, quia apud Dominum misericordia, et copiosa apud eum redemptio, et ipsi redimet Israel ex omnibus iniquitatibus eus. Benedictus Dominus Deus Israel, quia visitavit et fecit redemptionem plebis suae, et erexit a cornu salutis nobis in domo David pueri sui, sicut locutus est per os sanctorum qui e saecula sunt profetarum eus, salutem ex inimicis nostris et in manu omnium qui odorant nos, ad faciendam misericordiam cum patribus nostris, et memorare testamenti sui sancti.
I suppose he's been drinking again. Abraham,
patrem nostrum, datorem se nobis, ut sine timore, de manu inimiciorum nostrorum liberati
serviam.
Ego sum resurrectio et vita, qui credit in me, etiam si mortuus furit, vivet, et omnis qui vivit et credit in me non morietur in aeternum. Kyrie eleison, Christi eleison, Kyrie eleison.
did you say?
I said I think we need some help.
As I was saying, I think we need some petrol.
I'm sorry, it was my fault, darling. These roads twist so it's impossible to follow them.
It's not your fault. I should have dipped the tanker way back. Bone dry. I shall run on to see if I get some help, I'm afraid. Someone to tow us.
Shall I come with you?
No, it'll be quicker if I go alone.
All right.
Now, you stay here in the car. You'll be quite safe.
Gerald. Try not to be long.
I'll try.
Your car. Go.
Gerald, I was so frightened.
Oh, don't leave it there. Someone may want to come in.
They won't, sir.
Won't they?
No one ever comes in here, sir.
Why not? Why not?
Good night, sir.
What do you think, Gerald?
Well, we'd better get out of shelter.
Why can't you leave us alone?
We wondered if you might have a room.
A room? You want a room?
Yes, for the night.
Oh, you're strangers then, huh?
Well, yes.
Please come in.
Come in, please.
come in. Oh, you're wet. Oh, come in and dry yourself. Anna! Anna, we have people and guests. Come quickly. excuse me. What a night. What a night. You've left your horses outside?
We came by motor car.
Motor car? Oh, you must be a very rich young man.
It's my father's car. We borrowed it for our journey.
Oh, so? Oh, Anna. Anna, look. We have guests. Would you show these good people a room while I get their luggage, hmm? I'll get your luggage.
Oh, please, you'll get soaked. Wait until the rain stops.
Oh, I have an umbrella. Oh.
Will you sign here, please? What room do you want?
I beg your pardon?
Which room? They are all vacant. All except one.
Well, nothing too expensive. We still have a long way to travel.
5 marks?
Yes, that'll be fine.
It is the best we have. This way. I will bring you fresh linen and hot water. Is there anything else you require?
Some tea, perhaps.
Certainly. My husband will lay a fire for you, just as soon as he returns with your luggage.
Well.
Look. Look, see. Look.
Well?
Well, Anna, don't you see? This is rice. I found it among their luggage. Anna, don't you see what this means? They're just married. This is the honeymoon. Oh, Anna, look, we must do everything we can to make them comfortable, eh?
I am fetching them hot water now. What more can I do?
Oh, Anna. Anna, try to forget.
Please.
Just for tonight. For their sakes, please.
Tea, darling.
Show me a moment. That looks good.
Now wait.
Hello. But company.
What is it?
Someone has just delivered a letter. Pretty important, too, by the look of the carriage.
Oh,
what?
Come here.
What's wrong?
It's your ear. Stop it, darling. The tea will get cold, darling.
I know. Come in.
A letter for you, sir?
For me? Well, that's impossible.
Oh, no, it's addressed to you, the English gentleman, the Grand Hotel. That's us.
Well, who can it be from?
Ravna.
Yes, that's the Herr Dr. Ravna. Oh, very fine gentleman. He's lived at the chateau now for some years.
Is that the one we saw on the mountain back there?
Yes, my love.
He wants us to have dinner with him.
What?
Well, that's what it says. I should like to offer you my sympathy and extend an invitation to dine with me tonight.
You'll find the food at the hotel at... Well, I'll skip that bit.
My wife is a good woman, but a cook.
My carriage will call at 8, which I trust will be convenient. Well, what do you say?
I haven't anything to wear.
Nobody's forestalled you there. Come just as you are. We shall not be formal. I think we should go.
Oh, you should go, madame. My Herr Doctor's a very charming gentleman, and his table is one of the best in the country. It'll be an experience for you, madame.
Very well.
Good evening. Dr. Ravner is expecting us. Surprises.
Pleasant ones, I hope. You expected the inside of my house to be as unattractive as the outside, is that it?
Well,
if it were, I could not live here. I like only to be surrounded by beautiful things. And as I am fortunate enough to have the means to satisfy my wish. But there I go. Please excuse my appalling manners. We have so little company here that I sometimes forget how to behave. My name is Rab.
Gerald Harcourt. And my wife, Marianne.
Welcome to my house.
It was very kind of you to invite us.
It was indeed. I still can't quite understand how you found out about us so quickly.
To tell the truth, I was spying on your motor car. Such things are a rarity in these parts, and when I heard the sound, I used my telescope to watch you drive by.
Oh, we didn't. We broke down.
No, that is true. And before I could do anything to assist you, you had taken the initiative yourself, Mr. Harcourt. Now, please, come and meet the rest of my family.
That was beautiful.
Thank you, madame.
And now, may I introduce my children to you? My daughter, Sabina.
How do you do?
And Carl, my son.
How do you do?
Mr. and Mrs. Harcourt.
How do you do?
Will you play some more for us?
Later, I think, Carl, after dinner.
Why have you not been to see us, my sweet? Why have you waited so long? must know how much we have missed you. You should not be lying here all alone.
A series of scientific experiments, one of which went wrong. I was to blame, of course. I made a mistake. Scientists sometimes do. Anyway, that is why I can never return to the city of my birth. Why I live here, locked in this ornate coffin.
Oh, but it's beautiful here.
It often happens in life that the most beautiful things are made from the most unpromising of materials, don't you find? That wine we enjoyed at dinner, you did enjoy it, I hope.
It was delicious.
Made from grapes trampled by the feet of a peasant. 30 feet, as like as not.
Father!
Well, it's true, isn't it? That pheasant we ate, it had been hanging for five...
Oh, Father, please.
Perhaps Mrs. Hartford would like to hear you play.
Oh, please.
Something of your own, perhaps, Carl?
Certainly, Father.
Well, something you've composed yourself. How exciting.
Singularly lovely wife, Mr. Hartog.
Thank you.
No more now, Carl.
I'm sorry. I thought...
Marianne? I thought you were going to faint.
Perhaps it's too warm in here.
Oh, no, it's not that. It's just that she's had a rather long day. I think, if you'll excuse us.
Of course. Sabina, will you ring for the carriage?
Yes, Father. You will play for me again, won't you?
It will be my pleasure, madame.
Good night, Carl.
What are you going to do about your motor car, Mr. Harcourt?
Well, we need petrol. We plan to get to Kronenberg tonight. I know they keep a supply there.
But that's 30 miles away, and across the mountains, too. You wear off your track.
My wife is not a very good map reader, I'm afraid.
If you don't mind staying at the hotel for another day or so, I'll gladly send over for your petrol for you.
Thank you very much, sir.
Not at all. I'd invite you to stay here, only I'm expecting a number of guests.
Oh, no. The hotel will be fine, thank you, sir.
The food isn't that bad.
It was a wonderful evening. I shall never forget it.
Escape. Their motor has broken down. No petrol.
That's right.
They can't leave until I say so.
Your other guests.
Oh, yes. Come in. Well, wasn't I right? You're glad you went, yes?
Very, thank you.
And the food was good, yes?
You were quite right. It was absolutely excellent.
Yes. And the Herr Dr. Radner. Charming, no? Good night, sir.
Good night.
Good night, Mrs. Hartog.
Good night.
Brandy! The landlord! Brandy!
Another terrible day.
Four, is it? Five.
Will you ever forgive me for losing
six.
The way?
I might. I'll see. Now. Thank you.
please.
Well.
Oh, I'm sorry, but the door is opened. Anna and I wondered whether you'd get to have breakfast with us. We'd open the dining room, of course, but it's a bit damp.
Oh, we'd rather eat with you, wouldn't we?
Much rather.
Oh, in 5 or 10 minutes, then. Huh?
In 10 minutes, we'll be there.
Or 15.
Anna, you've laid an extra place again. Oh, my dear, I've told you so many times. Oh, good morning again. Come in, please, come in.
Oh, is our fellow guest joining us for breakfast?
Oh, no, he never eats.
How does he live, then?
On brandy and sour cream.
Oh.
Yes, I agree, but...
This weather won't do your business much good.
Business is never any good.
Surely, with the magnificent views you must get from here in good weather.
Well, the road is not much used by travelers.
I expect your bar is well patronized in the evenings, though, by the local people, the farmers.
It used to be.
Nobody comes here now.
Oh, why is that?
Some bread, madame.
Thank you. Frightened the life out of me. Here, look at this.
Tanya, aged 14. She's awfully like Anna, isn't she? Why does she hide it away?
Why does she lay a place for someone who never eats?
Shh. Be our fellow lodger. I think I'll have a word with him. Good morning. Herr Zimmer, isn't it?
Professor Zimmer.
My name's Harcourt. We're fellow guests.
When are you leaving?
In a day or two. And we've
good.
Why do you want us out of the way? Look, what's all the mystery?
What mystery?
Well, this hotel. Why does no one ever come here?
Excuse me, I have work to do.
Please, I'm only asking for information.
I advise you to ask no questions of anyone in this region.
Well, that puts me in my place. Nice to see you. Is your sister with you?
Yes, she's in the coach, but we can't stay.
Oh, but you must. I know Marianne will be delighted to see you. I'll call her.
We can't stay long. Look, the weather's changing.
Marianne, come on, look who's here. Come in, come in. Now, let me offer you some refreshment.
Sabina, this is a lovely surprise.
I'll call the landlord. I don't suppose he has any champagne.
No, please, we haven't time. I bring news of the petrol for your motor car.
My father has confirmed that there is a supply in Kronenbourg.
Oh, excellent.
It will take a little time. We had to send an ox cart for it. They are not so fast as motor cars.
But more reliable.
It will not be here till Sunday, I'm afraid.
Oh.
In the meantime, my father asks if you'll do him the honor of attending a party he is giving on Saturday night.
Oh, please say he'll come. The other guests will be so dark.
There'll be music.
And dancing?
It'll be a good party.
Please say yes. Won't it be very formal?
I know exactly what she's going to say. I haven't got a thing to wear. And in this case, it applies to me, too.
If you will not consider it impertinent of me to offer, I have a dress suit I could lend you, Gerald.
And I have the most heavenly dress. It's red chiffon and lace. And I'll send you my red velvet cloak to match. Oh, it'll look wonderful on you, Marianne. Oh, please, say yes.
Then, yes.
Oh, I'm so glad.
Well, I'm coming, too.
Oh, tell us some more about the party.
Well, a chef is coming from Paris just to prepare the buffet.
Oh, how wonderful.
And an orchestra is coming from Vienna.
Good morning. The weather seems to be improving. It's getting a little brighter, I think.
Please excuse us.
Drive on. Drive like the devil.
Oh, perfect, sir, perfect, but one little touch.
Thank you, Bruno.
Now, who's that handsome man?
Darling.
Is that all?
Oh, I'm speechless. You look terrific.
Thank you.
Oh, madame, may I add my congratulations? You look enchanting.
And thank you, Bruno.
Fits perfectly.
But that's thanks to Anna. She's worked wonders. Thank you, Anna, dear. Anna, you're crying.
Oh, my darling.
Would you care for a drink, sir, in the bar?
Hmm? Oh, good idea, Bruno.
Anna, did you once have a daughter of your own?
Why do you say that? It's not true. Why do you say it?
I'm sorry. I only...
That with the carriage, madame.
You look marvelous, darling.
Madame. Madame. I beg of you, be careful.
What are you talking about?
In God's name, be careful.
What do you think he meant, Gerald?
Oh, don't worry, darling. He's been drinking.
Thank you.
For your masks. Though in your case, Marianne, it will be a desecration.
But in mine, an improvement. Is that what you mean?
You know I did not mean that. Ah. Will you permit me?
Oh, yeah. I think it is an improvement.
Now, would you care for some champagne or would you like to dance?
Oh, I'd love to dance.
Oh, champagne for me.
In that case, may I? Champagne.
I couldn't. I feel quite dizzy as it is. I wonder where Gerald is.
You're hungry, I expect. Let me get you some supper.
No, I really must find Gerald.
I'll find him for you. Would you see that Mrs. Harcourt gets some supper? I won't be a moment.
she, by the way?
I don't know.
Maybe she's in the bar with that brother of yours.
Come on.
For my friend. A special glass, that sounds good. What about a special glass for you?
Later.
Oh. Through us all. Delicious. Ah, perhaps Marianne went outside.
Much to drink.
A little. Feels like a lot.
Come upstairs and have a rest. You'll feel better after.
Look here. You're not trying to lead me astray, are you? Because I'm a respectable married man.
Is that your room? Very pretty. After you.
Ladies and gentlemen, may I introduce a new disciple?
What's happened to the party?
Marianne? Carl, thank goodness.
What do you want?
What I want? What do you mean what I want? I want Marianne.
I don't know what you're talking about.
Look, if this is a joke, I'm terribly sorry.
This is no joke. You come here, get drunk, have to sleep it off. And now you say you want someone called Marianne.
Well, I do want her. She's my... What do you mean, someone called Marianne? You know who she is.
I do not know.
What?
You came here alone. And you can leave that way.
I came here alone.
Precisely. We're beginning to regret that we ever invited you. Hans, show this gentleman out, will you?
Yes, sir.
You saw me come here with my wife, didn't you? The lady with the red dress and the red cloak. Well, you opened the door for us!
You came alone, sir.
Carl, what's all this about?
Hans.
If you keep away from here, we'll set the dogs on you.
Marianne? Bruno!
Wife, sir.
My wife, you old fool!
You know what I'm talking about!
Don't, sir.
Who do you think all these clothes belong to, then? Done with her things.
God.
I understand you wish me to issue a warrant, sir. Is that correct?
Yes.
Against Herr Dr. Ravner and his family, of the Chateau Ravner?
Yes.
The most important residence in the district.
No doubt.
You realize, sir, that Herr Dr. Ravner is the most respected of gentlemen.
What has that got to do with it?
It has a great deal to do with it, young sir. You arrive here, a stranger, a foreigner, in fact. You are here for less than a week when you start accusing one of our leading citizens of abducting the lady you say is your wife.
She is my wife.
The landlord says you came here alone, sir. I have it here.
Well, what does his wife say?
She is a strange woman, sir. She refuses to say anything. I think she's a little...
Look, I didn't come here alone. I came here with Mrs. Harcourt, my wife.
Can you prove that, sir? I mean, for instance, where are her personal belongings? Her clothes?
They've disappeared.
Disappeared, sir?
Yes, disappeared. Well, stolen, if you like.
So you wish me to make out a warrant against the thief, sir?
No, I don't. I only want... the register.
There's nothing there, sir.
Professor Zimmer, please help me. My wife, she's disappeared.
I know, she's been kept in the chateau.
God. Thank God you know where she is.
Are you a religious man?
Not very.
Do you believe in God?
Yes.
And the devil? No, not the horn-headed, long-tailed devil of the picture books. I mean the real devil, the force of fundamental evil. He exists, you know.
I suppose he does. I never really thought about it.
The corruption of human beings by the devil can take many forms. Some of them so foul as to be beyond human belief. But because they are beyond belief doesn't mean they don't exist. Do you know what a vampire is?
Yes. I've heard of vampire bats.
No, not bats. Vampires. Human vampires. Beings who exist on the blood of other humans. When the devil attacks a man or woman with this foul disease of the vampire, the unfortunate human being can do one of two things. Either he can seek God through the church and pray for absolution, or he can persuade himself that his filthy perversion is some kind of new and wonderful experience to be shared by the favored few. And then he tries to persuade others to join his new cult. I had a daughter. She was all I had in the world. I idolized her. When she was very young, she ran away from home. Ran away to the city. She drifted in with a so-called smart set, and finally she was living with a certain man. Well, she came home eventually. What was left of her came home. She was riddled with disease. And she was a vampire. They even tried to follow her beyond the grave. Thank God I was in time. Her soul now rests in peace. The name of the man who corrupted my daughter was Ravener.
My God! And Marianne is with him! I must go there!
No, no! No, but now!
Yes, now! Now!
No, come here! Look! Look! The sun! The one thing a vampire can't tolerate. Now, your wife is safe until nightfall. And then, I shall do what I have to do. You, my friend, will remain here.
What did you put in
there? I've given you a drug. It'll make you sleep. Help to bring back your strength. You'll need it before the night is out.
Zimmer!
Please, listen to me. I need help, and I think you can help me. Your name is Tanya, isn't it? And your father is Herr Bruno, isn't he? Tanya, my wife is here somewhere. They've taken her, too. Do you know where she is?
Yes.
Will you take me to her, Tanya? I realize this may be very dangerous for you. But I promise I will give up my own life rather than let any further harm come to you. Please, Tanya, please, take me to her.
I understood my son told you not to come here again, Mr. Hartford.
Where is she?
Your charming wife. She is here, quite safe and happy. What are you going to do about it, Mr. Hartford? You must not expect your Queensbury rules here, Mr. Hartford. Now, about your wife.
You...
Please, let me say it for you. If you have so much as harmed one hair of her head, is that how it goes? Now, about your lovely young wife, Mr. Harcourt. I expect that you would like to see her. Sabina, would you be so kind as to go and waken her and bring her here? I will not say that she has not changed in any way, Mr. Harcourt. She has, as you might put it, grown up, tasted the more sophisticated, more exotic fruits of life.
Oh, my God.
God is hardly involved, Mr. Harcourt. Furthermore, having glimpsed these new horizons, I very much doubt if she will express any desire to return with you to England.
Mm.
Marianne, your husband is here. Don't you want to see him?
No, I only want to see you.
You've hypnotized her. She's in a trance. Marianne, take your eyes away from him. Look at me, Marianne. For God's sake, look at me!
Do you love him, Marianne?
No, I love you.
Don't you want him anymore?
No, I want only you.
Prove to me that you do not love him. Well done, my dear. Sit there. Tanya, I want you to initiate Mr. Harcourt into our society. Do you understand what I mean? Get off! We've got to get rid of the big servant. The others can't do anything without him.
Priest, Father Xavier. Well?
Yes.
I'm taking this.
Now?
Now. Well? What are you waiting for?
I can't.
What are you frightened of?
I can't tell you.
Then I'll tell you.
It's Ravenna, isn't it?
No.
You're afraid of what he may do to your daughter. You know, he's up there in the shadow with him, don't you?
They told me last night.
Do you want the same thing to happen to her?
No. No.
Then take that message.
Why don't I go?
No.
It'll be quicker.
The moon will soon be rising. Tonight is going to be a full moon. Come on.
You've got work to do.
I've been planning this night ever since I traced Ravenna to the chateau. From these medieval old books, I've pieced together the details of a ceremony. The ceremony to be performed when the moon is full and Capricorn in conjunction with Saturn, as it is tonight.
What ceremony?
A ceremony known as Corpus Diabolo Levitum, the evocation of the forces of evil. It is a way of forcing evil to destroy itself. Ah, Ravenna and all his acolytes are trapped in the chateau. Tonight I shall destroy them all.
Won't they have got away by now?
No, not now. I've sealed all the entrances of the chateau with a distillation of garlic. No vampire will pass that.
Well, what does he say? What does the master say we should do?
You are to remain calm.
Remain calm?
How can we remain calm?
Wait, Ravenna!
Of course, only the man to see it! No, you don't! You're not leaving till you promise to bring him here to us! Well?
We want to know the truth.
Why are we trapped here?
What's this force that's preventing us
from leaving? Why are we in danger? There's many things.
Yes, you are. They are trying to destroy us.
Then what are you going to do? You must save us!
Trust me!
What you're going to do?
They came here tonight to take the girl away because they did not want to risk her life while they were trying to destroy us. She was our protection then. She must come back and protect us again.
I start by drawing a simple circle, inside which I shall inscribe the great pentacle of Solomon. Like this. I leave a space there so that I can enter later. And now,
protect us during the ceremony.
Sword, ring, liquid, and horn. Ring, sword, liquid, and the horn.
Bagabi, Laka, Bakabe, Amak, Kahi, Akaze, Karelios. Yo, Zaki, Abati, Kaila, I pray thee, without hurt done to my person or my companion, in the name of thy master and mine, by the four words where the great god Agla said with his own mouth, by the nine heavens in which thou dwellest, by the strength of the sun and the moon, and by the power of fire and water.
I conjure thee, in the name of the great god Alpha, in the name of the mighty Beelzebub, appear!